All right, well, it's time to take the train with me and my pals here. For some reason, it lets us talk to those guys again, but we already did, so fuck them, screw them, we're out of here.
So, why are we taking the train if we can just fly?
It's kind of weird, like, when you bring back the part of the town, which the part of town that we brought back was the train, we can't actually get to the next area, even though we could technically fly over there, we do not have to take the train. But before we take the train, let's go grab a couple of these. It actually doesn't matter. If you, like, you may be wondering, like, why use the prompt at all. Oh, also, we're not allowed in the train. We still have to ride on top of it, because pets aren't allowed.
Wow.
Gravity
Bender's second-class citizens.
Seriously, like, we brought back this fucking train station. So yeah, you may be wondering, like, why can't we just fly? We could actually fly to the other part of town if we want, but it doesn't actually load up until you, bring back the missing part of town, which is always going to be the train station. But I got tired of, just riding on top, so, let's take a look in. Can we see what any of the passengers are doing? Anyone sleeping? Oh yeah, you may be seeing something down there. Keep that in mind for about a minute or two later.
Are we getting into, like, the casino district?
Yeah, so this is the pleasure. This is the pleasure district. This area has
the pleasure
two
dome.
Pleasure dome. Two parts of town here. We have the titty bar, which the other guy was telling us about before, and we have the school. Also, they knew that I'd be coming. They got all these monitors all up and ready. So I really like Pleajeune. It's not as big as the first part of town. But it's actually, I love the music, and this is around the time in the game where, like, collecting gems is actually worth it, because you no longer just get the, you get the occasional, like, one gemmer, but for the most part you start getting, like, 10, 20, and, like, this area knows how to take advantage of that. But first we're gonna accidentally slide, clip onto the wall, and, ride that part of the wall, which I didn't think was possible, but hey, we did it. The color scheme in Pleajeune is really good too, even though it looks like there are gems, like, literally everywhere. Like, fucking seriously, just dunk on us all the time. But it's okay, because I'm just gonna throw a couple of people at her or attempt.
Is our static field different here?
No, it just looks a little more colorful. No, our color, it, I guess it kind of stands out a little more in, like, a purpley grayish background. But yeah, Pleajeune is like one giant V. Even though it looks like it's about as big as Alt Noir, it's actually not, like, not really. Mostly because, like, we'll pop down here in a second. It doesn't actually go that, like, far. Like, Alt Noir had about, like, 4 or 5 different levels down. Pleajeune has, like, 2. So most of it is on a surface level. But, here, by the way, missed it by a second. If we just kind of hop down from where the train pulled in to grab a couple of those gems, that would be the first time in the game where one of these travelers is out in the open. And when you talk to them, it's not like they only say one thing in one area. It's whatever part in her, like, basically, if you found her for the first time and talked to her, you'd get the first piece of dialogue that we got from her before.
Okay, so you can find her in whatever spot, and it just advances the script.
Pretty much. Also, we saw a little bit of this guy when we were hanging on the side of the train there. So these guys are in every part of a new town, and they get to continue their story a little bit. In this case, he literally picked up exactly where he left off. Because in his mind, like, your conversation hasn't broken once. And he's gone again. So, being that we're doing another guided tour of Pleajeune, I figure before we get into that, let's do a little gem collecting. There are a lot of gems in this town, and, like, we could barely get, like, 50 from doing gem hunting in Aldoar. In this town, I managed to get, like, 500 just for about 10 minutes of gem hunting. Plus, it's a really beautiful town.
Sorry, I'm just kind of taking the music in.
The music. Music fits, like, this town so good. Also, a lot more shit we can break. Oh, and it's kind of hard to do, but... Alright, so now that we've grabbed all those gems, let's go ahead and start doing stuff in this town. Now we could go right into this challenge mission, but it just grabs me to go sliding down. Alright, get ready for Vita bowling. Strike!
Strike.
By the way, if we had come down here at the beginning, that's where the Traveler would have been. So literally, like, they're really trying to push it, like, hey, there's stuff around town if you want to go exploring and collecting and talking to people. So they make her really hard to miss. So this is another unique challenge mission. We got to pick people up and take them to the safety exit. Now, you would think that the way it looks like you have to go grab someone and then walk them over and drop them in the safe zone.
Like dropping them off like they're bombs.
Yeah, the hitbox for the hitbox for, like, the collection zone is actually, like, a couple of feet above that red line. And it's
so you really just kind of have to make a bombardment run above it.
Yeah, if you enter into that, like, that red haze, it counts as collecting them. And that's really the only way we can ever possibly get... In tight, confined areas like this...
I need my Dramamine!
In tight, confined areas like this, the camera does not react very well. So, like, the fact that we can drop them off without having to, like, physically plop down and walk them into the... safety zone is the only thing that makes this challenge mission possible to get gold. It's also one of the only reasons why I upgraded the stasis field as early as I did. Because otherwise, we would only be able to pick up one person at a time. And even with the stasis field upgrade, as we saw, like, last episode, it's still not perfect. It's actually pretty far from. So what you have to do is, like, really position yourself in between people and kind of hold down circle to be able to grab both of them. Also, every time we drop somebody in, they put new Nevi in, and as it said on the beginning there, like, look, I was right next to her, and for some reason it didn't pick her up that time. Nevi, if they hit you, you'll drop everyone you're carrying. Oh, I also got a little potted plant, too. So this challenge mission is actually pretty damn hard. Mostly because you do not want to ever be bringing just one person with you. So what you actually kind of got
to
do is
like a thing where you need to get an upgrade if you really want a good time.
Even with upgrades, getting gold in this took me about 5 attempts. you really just gotta kind of drop people together so you're always carrying at least one or two with you. If you haven't upgraded the stasis field at all, like, you're getting bronze. That's about it. Like, here, also, when more people start coming in, like, you'll get a lot more people that kind of, like, move and run around. So what I'm trying to do is pick this guy up and drop him just in front of that woman. And I got really lucky that I didn't get smacked there. And even with that, I'm still gonna, like, barely get gold, which is 500. Just because, like, if you don't take care of the Nevi on the ground, like, they'll just start smashing the hell out of you. Also, they start putting people later on, like, there are two guys who are on top of one of the fruit stands, so if you try and grab them, you're gonna grab everything in the stand instead.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a tough one. Like, that's, again, it's only for ones, like, it's not one that they repeat often, but it is one of the only reasons why I went ahead and upgraded the, stasis field as early as I did. Like, I'm a real big fan of, like, this color palette in general. So...
Yeah, it's not a palette you see. It reminds me of Black Velvetopia from Psychonauts.
Oh, damn, I can see that. Also, we're apparently blade-proof. Like, even just looking at this from afar, like, the school looks really nice from... Like, the draw distance in this game is incredible.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that, like, from the crux here, you can see everything in town. Is pretty damn incredible. So let's go ahead and fix down Main Street. Our janitorial work is never done. Now, we just had one annoying challenge mission, having to navigate these stairs up and down. Surely they're not gonna give us another challenge mission that involves us navigating these stairs up and down. Oh, also, every time you repair something, you get a tiny boost to your reputation. Sometimes it is just enough to get you, like, the next upgrade. Now, the last couple of challenge missions we've done have been pretty, like, pretty tough. This one is not. This one... We will smoke this one.
Like, so long as... You mean get smoked?
Smoke it, get smoked. Because these guys
smoking's
still...
bad, by the way.
Oh yeah, don't smoke.
You shouldn't smoke.
Also, don't miss your kick, too. Because that guy's hitbox kind of got, like, shoved into the restaurant. Or into the stand. So it kind of just, like, went right by him. But, like, if you've been upgrading the gravity kick to this point and upgrading your gauge usage to this point, you'll be able to pretty much one-shot nearly everything here. Like, these aren't special Nevi. These are just normal guys. And, like, they hand out time extensions like they're candy. But it's pretty much just, like, one gigantic loop of take care of the ones down there, take the stairs up, take care of the ones up here, take the stairs up, take the stairs down, and just keep looping. Occasionally they'll give, like, a red core Nevi, but for the most part, not really. If your gravity gauge runs out, you can just kind of land for a little bit, but it comes back really quickly. We've also been upgrading our gauge refill, which is, like, when we completely run out, how long it takes for it to come back. It's a pretty important thing to upgrade to. Also, this barrel kind of gets, like, stuck in the wall there. Until it just explodes.
It seems like they want you to use the screw attack on the stairs.
I do that at some point. It doesn't actually go as far as you... You would think that, right? But it's actually better to use the screw attack on these guys down here. Because all the Nevi on the stairs are still just a one-kicker. but if you get like a red core of the Lance guys, they can take 5, 6, 7 hits before they die. But if you're using a screw attack, it's one kick, they're dead. Like, see, even the red Nevi there just got wrecked in one kick because we're far away enough from them. See, if you use the screw attack on these guys, you make it up about halfway up.
I see.
Which is nice, but if I had that, I could have dropped it here and torn through, like, this guy is going to be a real pain in the ass because he's going to be a dual red-headed, a dual red core, Shell Nevi. So this guy takes, like, 6 or 7 kicks to die. Also, this is one of those missions that's tremendously easier playing on the PS4 rather than the Vita, because turning around is just so much easier to do with the R stick than having to...
Some of these areas, I can't see how you would ever do it with, like, the touch thing on the Vita.
When I got gold on this one, I literally put my computer chair in the middle of the room and spun around it like an astronaut. You have to do that for some of these. Alright, like, look at what the spiral cannon does here. Like, those are three...
I kind of missed that.
Oh. It kind of just tore through the three lancers like they were nothing. Like, the gravity kick, like, the bounce back from the gravity kick can be a little annoying, but if you evade back in the direction you were, you'll almost always be in a perfect position to get another really, like, unobstructed kick in.
I like this. It's like, what if you had a game where you just went around headbutting things?
Do one thing and
then
this
one,
really
you
well.
Can fly. You can, like, just fly headbutt things.
The game... Well, I kind of dropped a little bit of an explanation in chat about it, but, her kick, the gravity kick, looks and feels almost exactly like Kamen Rider's kick, the Rider kick. Kamen Rider being basically, like, one of the two characters that started, like, Power Rangers, superhero, Sentai in Japan. That was a comic where they made human-animal hybrid monsters. An organization wanted to take over the world basically made these things, and Kamen Rider was a man that was going to be fused with the grasshopper. But
managed... Oh, that's why his mask looks like a bug.
Exactly. And he broke free at, like, they broke him free at the last minute before the brainwashing could take effect. So he's been fighting the forces that did that to him. And because he has the high jumping power of a grasshopper, his ultimate move is the Rider kick, where he jumps in the air and then just kicks the bejesus out of them. So really, like, I think of, like, this playing the Spider-Man game on PlayStation, where the game itself wasn't that great, but the act of just flying around town, web-slinging all over the place... Oh, by the way, this is their, they don't have the fish with the, candy gem. They get a actual woman with holding fire. You know, a little more dignity and respect. But, yeah, kind of like, oh, but, well, actually, I'll get back to that in a second. First, we gotta do that. And then, come on, everyone, let's go to school. Oh, they're playing hooky today. But yeah, kind of like playing the Spider-Man 2 game for PlayStation, where the game itself wasn't really all that great, but man, it felt really good just web-slinging around. I kind of feel like this is where they got the idea from for this game. Like, hey, let's just make a game where flying around kicking stuff feels a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm.
And then let's,
like,
build the story around it.
Not enough games do that, where you can just, like, fly around and explore and have fun.
Like, I know I made a little montage of it, but... honestly, like, that's why I kind of kept some of it in this part, at least. But flying around town and just getting gems is sometimes, like, the funnest part of this game. Particularly, like, with the soundtrack playing, you feel like you're on, like, a little bit of, like, a Disney vacation. So the school here is fucking massive.
Oh, and why does a Pleasure Dome need a school?
I don't know why they would put the, like... That would be like opening, like, Yale or like moving Yale, like, to the middle of New Vegas, like, or Las Vegas, New Vegas, Las Vegas, Nevada. But you know what? I guess it works. I think they just wanted to, like, get this next part of the storyline out of the way, and they're like, well, nothing else really makes sense unless, like, we have half of a Pleasure Dome that we can't make into an entire city. And we have a school that we can't make it into an entire city. So fuck it. We're gonna put like the gambling kitty bar part of town next to like a fucking Ivy League school that's bigger than the actual part of town itself.
Just didn't feel like getting the rest of them, huh?
I kind of did, and then I realized that from this point on, we're never going to have to worry about gems again. Like, for each challenge mission that we get a gold on here, we get 900 gems out of that. In addition to the fact that you can get a couple hundred just by, like, flying around. Like, we're already at 2,500. Getting another, like, 10 wouldn't matter. So another sliding race. And I can already hear you thinking, boy, I wonder if the camera's gonna goof up big time in this one. Yeah. Yes, it is.
The answer is yes.
So it's around here where they start putting, like, boxes in the way of your... Whoa!
Whoa!
Yeah,
had a little seizure there.
A tiny bit. Glad my capture card can keep up with that. I'm like, oh shit, I bet I just lost my recording. But I didn't. But yeah, they start putting, like, actual obstacles in your way in this sliding mission, and not just people who we immediately run over.
What are the bubbles?
The bubbles restore your gravity gauge, which we don't really have to worry about, because... We have so many upgrades.
Wow, 0.4 seconds.
Yeah,
oh, wait,
even
1.4.
Even with that, like, even with getting caught up in that, like, camera swing for, like, 5 whole seconds, that's how fast your sliding gauge is.